Hey, this week in our devotions, we're talking about contemplative prayer. Love what Pete Gregg does. If you've not yet picked up his book, How to Pray, please, you'll be better for it. And I love the audio. You can't beat the man's accent, and he's just a phenomenal writer and storyteller. I think that when I think about contemplative prayer, probably I would say that in my personal experience, I don't know that there's been anything that has been more transformative for me as an individual. Transformative in that contemplative prayer brings me to the space and place where I quiet every inner and outer voice to attend to God. Where I, it's the practice of being absent from people and things to attend to God. Those are both little quotes from Dallas Willard. It's that space and place where I recognize that in solitude, it's not about isolation or loneliness, but separation from the things that clutter your mind and distract me from being alone with God, to hear and make our connection with Him as strong as it can be for each and every day. And so for me, contemplative prayer is the foundation of all my other prayers. In fact, it literally has shaped the way I define a prayer. I gave a definition a few weeks ago that prayer is my constant consciousness of Christ's presence in me and the continual integration of who He is into who I am, expressed through a frequent dialogue to accentuate His presence and purposes for my life. That's a little heady, I know. But literally, my space in contemplative prayer where I come and I contemplate, right? The idea of contemplation is to focus one's attention on some singular aspect of God or something God's done, a trait that He has, a work that He's doing. And when that focus can begin to not just connect intellectually or mentally, but also emotionally and spiritually, relationally, it changes the relationship. When you can begin to really allow God's presence to change the way you think about Him, and the way He thinks about you changes the way you think about you. I like to say that it is where we learn to be present with the presence of God. It's where we learn to be present to ourselves and the presence of God. Because when you are present with God, His love for you, His crazy passion for you, it will not leave you unaffected. It will change you from the inside out. This week, we'll talk more about contemplative prayer. Just join me in a moment of contemplation. Lord, we pause and think about Your extravagant love. Lord, that is so vast and beyond us that the Apostle Paul would pray and intercede that we would grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of God. This love that surpasses knowledge. Jesus, enable us this week to go more deeply into Your love. With all that we are, we love You, Lord. We contemplate You. Looking forward to being with you this week. God bless.